हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम डॉक्टर विजय प्रकाश एंड टुडे आई विल बी टॉकिंग टू यू अबाउट हाउ टू मैनिपुलेट अल्जिनेट एंड हाउ टू मेक एन इम्प्रेशन अल्जिनेट इम्प्रेशन एंड मेक एन इम्प्रेशन इन द पेशेंट्स माउथ. सो फर्स्ट थिंग बिफोर मेकिंग एन इम्प्रेशन, वन थिंग विच इज़ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट इज ट्रे सिलेक्शन. सो वी हैव टू सिलेक्ट द ट्रे अकॉर्डिंग टू द मुखोलिया, जॉ साइज ऑफ द पेशेंट एंड दिस इज द लोअर टीथ. So, we'll appropriately take the tray, the maxillary tray. Whenever we are selecting a tray, we have to make sure that all the teeth are covered. Mukholo jara, and you also cover the entire palate all around. You can see this. So all around, so you have enough space for the material to come in. So this is fine. So you select the UT tray, U2 tray, and for the lower, again you have to follow the same thing. All the teeth are covered in this. Jeep ko upar leke jao. Ask the patient to make the tongue movements. Jeep ko upar leke jao. बाहर निकालो. यस, सो मेक श्योर दैट द पेशेंट कैन मेक टंग मूवमेंट्स व्हेन यू आर सेलेक्टिंग दिस ट्रे. सो दिस इज ऑल्सो फाइन. दिस इज L2 ट्रे. सो नेक्स्ट वी कम टू मैनिपुलेशन ऑफ अल्जिनेट. फॉर दिस एज वी नो दैट अल्जिनेट इम्प्रेशन इज सप्लाइड इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पाउडर. एज यू कैन सी हियर, this is a non-chromatic alginate impression material and this will be mixed in a proper ratio with the water and accordingly we'll be making an impression. So these are the selected trays, that is L2 and U2. First thing, whenever we are making an impression in the patient's mouth, we should go for a lower impression. The reason being that the patient get used to the material, first thing. Secondly, chances of gagging is not there, patient cooperation is better. And also, it is important whenever you are making an impression, the positioning of the patient head, that is very critical. So I will be telling you that also, how to position the patient whenever you are making an impression. Now I'll start with the lower impression. For a lower impression, you'll be taking around 1.5 to 2 scoops. Although 2 scoops is more material for a lower tray, so we will be taking, we can discard the remaining material. So how do you take 2 scoops? This is 1 scoop. This is how you manipulate. Another scoop you are going to take. Scoops of material. Now what about the ratio for alginate impression material is 2:1, that is 2 parts of water and 1 part of the powder. 1 part of powder means that is around 9 grams of powder, and 2 parts of water means it is around 18 ml of water. So what we'll be taking, we'll be taking water and alginate. Although you should take water first and then sift the alginate in this. So since I have taken powder, so I have to be very careful when I'm mixing the water. So this is how you're going to just make sure that you wet the powder particles. And then with the curved part of the spatula, you have to scrub against the walls of the bowl and make a figure of 8 motion so that you have a smooth homogeneous mix and it is easy for you to manipulate in the patient's mouth. So what you will be doing, this is a good smooth homogeneous mix. You load it onto the impression tray. You have to be fast because otherwise your working time with the material will reduce. This is ready for you to place it in the patient's mouth. A lower impression, you have to make sure that the lower jaw is parallel to the floor. Place the tray like this. The handle should be in the center and make the movements. In the lower arch, what movement you will be making? That would be upward, inwards and sidewards if you are talking about the buccal vestibule part, like this. For the lingual aspect, ask the patient to make tongue movements. Jeep ko upar leke jao, upar, bahar nikalo, daaye leke jao, baaye leke jao. So you'll be asking the patient to move the tongue and touch the palate, and ask the patient to move the tongue outwards and then move sidewards in order to record the lingual aspect. Allow the material to set. In a normal, since this is a normal set alginate impression material, the setting time is around 2 to 4.5 minutes. And you have another type, that is type 1, that is a fast set. The setting time for fast set material is around 1 to 2 minutes. So the uses of an alginate impression material, as we know, it is used to make impressions for a dentulous and edentulous, and it is used to make impressions for making your study cast, your study models. It can be used as a duplicating material, since this and agar-agar, which is a reversible hydrocolloid, it can be used as a duplicating material. And also it can be used, very commonly used in for making impressions for maxillofacial processes. So these are the uses of alginate impression materials. You have to allow the material to set. Apart from this, one thing which we have to keep in mind is what is the basic composition of alginate. Alginate basic composition is, these are ester salts of alginic acid, and you have diatomaceous earth and calcium fluorides, potassium sulfate. All these are components. Apart from this, coloring and flavoring agents, you can add your acylators and retarders depending on the manufacturer, how they are supplying it to you. Apart from this, alginate can also be color changing alginates, which can be chromatic alginate, which changes the color. And how does it work? Whenever you are mixing the powder with the liquid, it forms a sol, and then this sol converts into a gel. So once it converts into a gel, that is the time when you have to remove it from the patient's mouth. So it is hardening enough, as we can see. Now, how do you remove it from the patient's mouth? That is also very critical. Whenever you are removing from the patient's mouth, you have to remove it in one snap, because if you start and removing it slowly, chances of tearing of this material is there. Although you know that alginate and agar material, which are hydrocolloids, have a poor tear strength, so chances of tearing of the material is there. So that is the reason you should remove the material in one snap. So this is how you have to make sure that you break the seal, if there is any, and remove it in one snap. This is the lower impression, as you can see. Wash the impression and then it is ready to be poured with your gypsum product. So then we'll go with manipulation of the alginate impression material in the upper arch. For that, we'll be taking 2 scoops of powder, and accordingly we'll be taking water. So this is 1 scoop. Again, you'll be taking another scoop of alginate powder. Accordingly, you will be taking the water. First, make sure that you wet the powder particles. That is very important. Make sure that you wet the powder particles nicely. Make the once you have wet the water powder particles, then you will just press it against the walls like this and make a figure of 8 motion. Now this will give you a very good smooth mix. You can see how smooth and good mix is this. You pick this up, load it onto the tray, the maxillary tray like this. Similarly, you're going to do for the other side. You need not place it here because then there will be an excess material. Then it will flow down the throat of the patient. Now this is ready to be placed in the patient's mouth. For the upper, make sure that you don't recline the patient too much. Place the tray in the center like this. First the anterior part and then the posterior part, and then manipulate. Make the functional movements, make the border movements. Outward, downwards and inwards. Also sidewards when you are manipulating in the buccal region. तीला छोड़ी है मुंह खोलो कीप द हेड ऑफ द पेशेंट डाउनवर्ड्स इफ द पेशेंट गैग्स एट दिस टाइम आस्क द पेशेंट टू पुट हिज हेड डाउनवर्ड्स बिकॉज देन द मटीरियल एक्सेस मटीरियल नॉट गोइंग टू फ्लो डाउन द थ्रोट एंड द पेशेंट विल नॉट गैग. If otherwise, you have to keep the patient's head straight. That is very, very important because normally we see students making this mistake. They'll keep the head of the patient reclined, and whenever they are making an impression, the excess material is going to flow downwards towards the throat, and then the patient have a severe gagging effect. So this is very important. The head positioning of the patient should be kept in such a way that he does not gag. We'll allow the material to set, and once this material is set, then as we have removed it in the lower impression, we are going to do the same in the upper impression. That is, we are going to remove it in one snap rather than in a small slow motion. Rather than that, we'll be removing this material in a snap. Once you have the impressions, both the impressions, you can disinfect that in 2% glutaraldehyde. You can also use iodophores for disinfecting the impressions after washing the impression, of course. And then you pour it with appropriate gypsum product. Mostly primary impression, you use type 3 gypsum product, that is dental stone, for making these study casts, study models, and your primary cast. Alginate is an elastic, irreversible hydrocolloid material, and it can be used where you have undercuts. Although in a very severe undercut, it should be avoided because it has a poor tear strength, chances of tearing of the alginate impression material is there. So in those cases, you should avoid using alginate impression material. Although in an undercut area also you can use alginate impression as it is an elastic impression material. So now I think it is the alginate impression is set, so we can remove this. Remember, as I told you, we have to remove it in one snap this way. So this is the impression, as you can see, but there is certain area which you have slightly more pressure there. So in those cases, either you discard the impression and make a new one, or you mark this area and mark it on the cast, and accordingly you can manipulate in your impression trays if you want to. With this, we come to end of our video. Thank you for watching the video.